This is a lovely, beautiful day in the big sky. We're just everything already finished, official part, and we're doing something for pleasure and to give you some small lesson, short lesson. And this is a very fit guy, as you see, and he will be my student for the short lesson.
Bret Ellis from Alabama,
Bret Pitt,
CrossFit Rabid.
You know. Okay, Bret will be my student, and we will see on which stage he is. I have no idea as well. So he's
bottom stage.
I know him, but I don't see he is running yet, and we will see it together right now. Bret, you're very nice gentleman. You are incredibly fit. I have no doubt. And your fitness level is intimidating for me, you know. But unfortunately, your running is sucks. Please tell me exactly what are you doing?
What am I doing?
Yes, you are.
I guess just trying to move forward.
Okay, it's very indefinite and uncertain, you know. So what I will teach you to make your run completely certain and definite.
Okay.
In what you are doing, you know. So first misleading thing, you think that because you're strong you have to use your muscles.
Okay.
Right?
Sure.
I guess this is what I saw when
okay.
you run. Okay, first rule for running: do not use your muscles.
Okay.
It's not you should use muscles, it's your body weight will
okay.
use these muscles.
Okay.
So bend your knees. It's called pose, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Then you will be on one leg. Right now we will do it with only two legs for your confidence and more comfortable condition. So now drop any thought that you need use muscles, you know.
Okay.
What you're using right now, it's enough. I will ask you even less now.
Okay.
Less. Okay, good. From this point you have to just fall. Yep. Right? Exactly. Only you have to know when this falling will be interrupted into another fall. So falling is like that. Fall. You see, this is what you do. You see, it's such small amount of falling like this will give you incredible speed of running.
Okay.
You don't need more than. So when you will run now, just fall like this.
Okay.
Each step.
Uh-huh.
This falling is too much for you. You're afraid this falling.
Okay.
Because you start project your falling with that movement forward. It's called
okay.
overstriding, you
okay.
know? This is what your brain does. You're fearful. If you are going too much fall, what are you doing?
Yeah, trying to catch yourself.
Yes, you're saving yourself. So you're stopping.
So try me a little more upright.
Don't be falling from here.
Okay.
Not from here.
Okay, makes sense.
This
Good.
Is bend over. This is what falling. This is just you see
yeah,
it.
Right.
General sacrifice.
Okay.
So you're
yep.
falling here.
Okay.
Yep. Okay. Go ahead.
Yep.
All right. It's much better. What did you feel different when I corrected you?
It literally did feel like I was being pulled.
Yes, right. Because this is GCM.
Right.
I mean, it's general center of mass.
Right.
And then you start falling. Falling point is your point of support.
Right.
It's above the foot. And you start, you see this?
Right.
It's not upper body.
Sure.
It's that point.
So it's a lot more upright.
Yeah. As you see, changes already going. So what did you feel?
It's just a lot more fluid. A lot,
right.
a lot lighter, a lot less exertion.
Right. Okay, did you feel less muscular efforts?
Oh, sure.
Oh, this is what sign. Good running characterized by no efforts.
Okay.
You see?
Right.
Light. Now we get another point, how to fall.
Okay.
It's this position, you see? Yeah,
mm-hmm.
like this. Just bounce a little bit. You see, check. It's called pose.
Okay.
Pose is a position of the fall. It's only one single position in running, no matter what you run. Marathon or sprint, it will be the same simple falling position,
okay.
Running pose, you know.
Okay.
You have to keep your foot under the hip. This is
okay.
The condition what you have to have, and perception. If your foot is here, look. If it's here, you cannot fall.
Right.
Because it will be counterbalance.
Right.
It's mechanics.
Sure.
If your foot will be here, it will be counterbalance as well.
Right.
And you will not fall. Don't point anything. This is neutral position, you see? Your foot in neutral position.
Anatomically, neutral. Don't do anything. You see, like this. You either
doing dorsiflexion.
My dorsiflexion bad?
Pointing.
Okay, just
don't
let it hang.
Don't do anything. Okay, this is what. Now, you will run by falling and keeping this pose.
Okay.
I mean, reproducing basically.
Right.
Too much.
Okay.
This speed of falling not coincide between each other, you know? So,
okay.
Basically, you producing noise of effort with no necessity.
Okay.
When you will run, I will correct you. You see how much less?
right.
You see, you're just overdoing.
Right.
And we have to reduce these things. It's a pose, you see? Just simple, like that. It's almost like jogging, right? And now, don't change anything, but add to this only falling. Right? More falling, right? Right? Mm-hmm. Yes? Good. Brad, take off efforts.
Okay, more?
Less efforts.
Less effort.
I shouldn't see that you are a strong man. I know this. I don't need more information about this. Rhythm now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Excellent. You're a good student. Describe me. What did you feel?
I think more of it's trying to not overthink it and just relax and kind of let it happen.
Of course, let it happen. You see, you are using now a proper definition because running is let it go, you know.
Right.
Let it happen because it's a falling. It's not your business, it's gravity does. So let it happen. Go ahead. Good job. Yes. Good job, Brad.